Yeah!
Sound the war drums.
I made the soundtrack for this game. Did you know that? I was like,
I'm your grandfather.
And then they put this out.
What's that song, Air Force One, where it's like, hoo-ha, hoo-ha?
That's Bear Force
Bear
One.
Force
you were very
one,
close. By the way, welcome back to Let's Play Middle Earth. That's what
it's also
called.
A toy box song.
Hang on, man. Let me get there. Let's Play Middle of Earth, Shadow of Mordor, but leave out the Middle Earth part. It's just, it's a formality. And this is part three, if I didn't say that. I think I just did, but that's fine. I'm not 84 hours into the game. I feel like I left my Xbox on for a bit, but I am 35% in. Every time you load the game, he chats with his dead wife.
Like Dexter's dad? She just kind of shows up to give advice?
Only in the loading screens, though. That'd be funny if Dexter's dad only came to talk to him during the commercials. He was just like, Dexter,
hey,
quick.
Listen, we got 15 minutes. What's up?
So I've pretty much done everything in this whole first map. Besides the story missions. As I said,
yeah,
I was doing the side quests
progress.
And stuff.
I missed a lot while I was sleeping.
You did.
Thanks for the nap. Appreciate it.
I think there's a second map, or at least a third. There's definitely at least one more than this. But I don't know if there's three. But yeah, I pretty much ran around. I did all the collectibles. I fucking leveled up a shitload. Let's go over here. I went pretty silly with the upgrade, so I'm all the way down here. I only have one more thing to unlock with the next tier, for power. But I can kick some ass still. I haven't got any war chiefs yet in the main game, like in the campaign. But I did buy the season pass. So with that, I got a bunch of extra shit. And with that, there's some modes where you can fight war chiefs and shit. And basically, the whole point of all that extra stuff is you don't get any experience or anything. But if you get runes in there, you can keep the runes for the main game. So I got a bunch of rare runes or epic runes. They're the yellow ones. So, for example, I got one that makes me immune to poison, which I can't remember if I got poisoned in the last part or not. But basically, when you're poisoned, your screen turns green and the Y button counterattack option does not appear over enemies' heads. So you get your ass kicked while you're poisoned. So, like, I'm immune to that. And there's some other shit I got, but it's a good way to get good runes, because you can just fight war chiefs over and over and over again and get good equipment from them.
How many chiefs do you have left to take down?
Well, I didn't find any yet in this game, is what I'm saying. I haven't encountered them yet.
Sorry, what are they called then, I guess, what you've already fought?
The captains.
The captains, yes. Okay.
Yeah, well, there's
there's
an unlimited number. They come forever. There's no limit to them. Like, there's an achievement for killing all five war chiefs before... like somebody rises through the ranks and replaces him.
Sweet little Roxas, where does he die?
Desecrate your body and your corpse will join them.
You and your hobbit bones.
What an ugly fucking hobbit.
He was a cute hobbit when he was Smeagol.
No, he wasn't.
He was
another treasure.
Kind of cute.
Your dreams.
In like a Pillsbury Doughboy way.
We will prove ourselves, great master. We will prove we are friends.
Take us to it.
Yes. Come. This way. Come on.
Do you think he's going to get friendship bracelets?
Yeah. No, it's one of those necklaces that's like half a heart.
I made this for you, yes! Friends! Yes!
Gollum has the best side, and we have the friend side.
I wonder what his penis looks like.
I choose to believe it's non-existent.
It's there, for sure.
No, he's like a Ken Barbie doll.
No, he's
it's
there.
It's just flat.
That's like saying Frodo has no dick.
Probably.
Like, he definitely
does. Did you
does.
See him fucking any hobbit ladies?
I mean, I saw hobbit ladies, so, you know, and like kids and stuff. I assume they procreate somehow.
Yeah, but they're not Frodo's kids. Maybe he's a eunuch.
Yeah, but the point is, hobbits in general have dicks.
Yeah, they do.
So he's probably got a dick. What's his asshole's name?
Smeagol?
Smeagol, yeah. Smeagol probably had a cock at some point.
Yeah. He definitely did, and he definitely put the ring on it, and that's how he was transported first.
That's how he fell in love with it. Yeah. Is that what he did? He fucked it. He's like, my precious.
Yeah. He just wanted to go for a quick masturbation session.
He's got a tiny dick.
Got thrown into the Wraith world.
That makes sense. The big, you know what they say, the bigger their feet, the smaller their dick. It's like the reverse with the Hobbit. So I'm trying to follow Gollum. He ain't fucking moving. Move, asshole.
Maybe you have to guide him, possibly.
Don't do shit. How do you guide someone you're supposed to follow?
Go
all right,
on,
I'm following you. Let's go this way. Doesn't make any sense. Nasties. I'll fucking shoot him in the face. But as something like with the War Chief achievement, there's one for killing all five before like a recruit surpasses them, and then there's another achievement specifically for that, for like taking like a low level grunt or some shit, leveling up to a captain, and then basically leveling him up to a War Chief. You do that by basically getting murdered by him, and as he kills you, he'll level up. But you can get both in one game because the War Chiefs will constantly replenish themselves. The upside is, since I did that little side mission, even though it wasn't campaign related, there's five War Chiefs in it, and I killed all five of them, so I already got that achievement. So that was pretty sweet. So I don't have to deal with that in the campaign. I imagine those challenges, a bunch of them, will be good for pain in the ass achievements like that. So, like I said, I just bought the season pass, and it comes with like some crap basically. Now it's not that amazing. The runes are pretty good, but I just bought it now to have it for the DLC that's going to come out, I assume, at some point. All right, we're going around.
Full move a muscle, sucker.
Excellent.
It's got a nice singing voice.
Fish heads.
Roly-poly fish heads. Fish heads. Fish heads. Eat them up. Yum. You are the only person I've ever met who knew that song.
Yeah. I don't know where it's from either.
I don't know either. It's like an old fucking song that should not... We shouldn't know it. It's from like the 50s or 60s or something. I'm telling you.
I think my mom used to sing it. That's why
I'm telling you. But I've never met anyone in my life that knew that song besides you.
Yeah, fish heads, man.
It was meant to be.
He'll show us, then he'll take it. He'll show us, then he steals it. No, no.
I don't know why this is so comical. Listening to the Gollum fucking serenade us.
Maybe it's funny for me because all I'm picturing is Carrie guiding us along.
Wow. Shots fired on Carrie. Holy shit. You think Carrie looks like Gollum?
No.
Damn, Carrie.
He's like our happy half hobbit friend. You know?
He's half hobbit?
Yeah.
Why is he half?
Because Carrie gets like creepy sometimes, you know.
So why does that make him a hobbit?
No, that's his other half. That's the non-hobbit half, where it's like, Carrie, no, you minx, you calm down there.
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. You're not making any sense. I don't think anyone in the hobbit world is half hobbit.
Is that the whole point of Gollum? He used to be a hobbit, but then he got warped by the ring?
So he's a whole fucking hobbit. He's not half. He's still a hobbit. How would that make him half of a fucking hobbit? That's like saying if you're a human and, like, you lost your legs, you're half a human. You're still a fucking human. Like, what the hell are you talking about?
No, it's like...
I mean, poor example, because technically you're, like, half of a human, I guess, because there's, like, half of you.
Exactly.
But that's just a little insulting. But Gollum didn't get any fucking smaller. He's the same size. He's still a hobbit.
Yeah.
He's just a fucking psychotic, deranged hobbit. What am I fucking looking for here? Find the vision artifact. All right. I'm just going to run around. We got a bunch of explosive barrels everywhere. That's sweet.
I lied.
Arrows.
Gollum is pugs.
That's a little more likely. I'll give you that. Shots not fired, Fugs, except the truth. What am I going to say? Where am I going?
Also, thanks for editing these videos, Caden.
Yeah, although I'll probably make this one, so you can thank me. But yeah, Fugs made the other two. Where the hell am I going? Let's run up here. I bet I can see it from up there. I'm not leaving. Shut up.
Jesus.
I'm still here.
Just cut to the part where
you know,
find the mission.
I went
area.
And did all this shit so I wouldn't like waste time running around when we record. And I'm still doing it. I can't escape it. God. Damn it. I missed the sprint thing. Oh, also, I stopped following this blue light, and I don't know
why. Doesn't the trail guide you?
Yeah.
Just like the blue studs.
Yeah. I've been doing side quests, man. You know what side quests are? Just stabbing people in the throat for like 50 hours. So I forgot that I actually have to do things and follow things. Here we go.
You showed me that earlier. That was one of your skill upgrades, too. You can instant kill, like, was it 3 people in a row now?
No. You're
Five?
Crazy. None. Zero.
10?
I don't know what you're talking about.
20.
Just stop. He yelled, by the way.
He really liked that crown. It's beautiful.
Sup? Elf? Is that an elf?
Yes.
No?
You're having like elvish flashbacks right now.
Oh yeah, that's elf. Okay.
For sure.
Dude.
They're in Rivendell, I believe.
You are the lore expert, sure.
It's true.
Who's this guy? Who's that guy?
Spike from Buffy.
Who's the other guy? What's that?
A hammer.
Who's that?
It is so fine a gift.
What's the gift? So I think that dude might be the dead dude, the ghost guy.
Yeah, that's like absolutely in is.
Because we use that hammer to whack stuff.
Did you not recognize that through the cutscene?
Not really.
Oh, I seriously did, but...
Good for you.
Come here!
Kick them in the face.
Release him.
Now give me my crown back.
Why do we chase these dreams? They offer no answers, only more questions! These are not mere dreams. With each vision, my power grows stronger.
Still looks after us. Rangers should go now. Very dangerous here.
Is that a threat, bro?
We wait at the ancient tower for him.
You couldn't tell me like 30 seconds earlier? You did nothing. You're like, you should go, and then they showed up anyway. So I haven't even fucking fought these yet. This is the first time I'm fighting ghouls. It's funny because I'm pretty overpowered as far as where I am in the game. Wraith Flash. Interesting. Unleash a powerful flash of light which damages and stuns Uruks or kills ghouls. Well, that's sweet. So there's a shitload of abilities that I don't have yet because you have to do the main story part. But case in point this. Okay, close the fucking menu! Christ, there's a lot of these little assholes. And, there we go. Alright, alright.
Why is there a light source inside of them?
What's up?
I'm wondering what the light source inside of them is.
What are you talking about?
They're glowing.
Their eyes?
Yeah, and their mouths.
They're fucking monsters. Have you ever seen a movie? Holy shit, enough! Damn, son. I don't even know how getting hit works, because I feel like I'm just getting my ass kicked.
Yeah.
But my multiplier's not going down. Yeah, I am. I definitely am, but it's not going down. Alright, well, so I got
works.
I got an upgrade that enables you to do those special attacks at times 5 instead of times 8. That's what your brain was trying to say earlier. When you kept that saying, do several in a row. I can't do any in a row. But my multiplier can go up, or I can use those combo attacks at times 5 now.
It's foreshadowing.
All right, so we did that. I'll hold off on that shit. Ooh, we got a new little fucking sword thing.
You're not going to meet up with Gollum at the Black Gate?
He needs you, bro. There's no mission. That's this over here.
Yeah.
Gollum is hungry. He hungry to lead the Bright Master to the artifacts. I guess I can't deny him that then. So let's just follow Gollum.
Get him some fish. Also, don't read my hands, Xbox.
Yeah, stop. You're all hands today. Go away. The fuck out of here. Hang on.
It's making the groping signal.
Now I'm actually trying to do it.
Boobies.
Okay, so if I grab, this connect isn't working. How did you activate this? You do it.
I literally just stretched.
Well, now it's on the fucking screen!
I'm so sorry.
Xbox,
I wasn't trying to grab your boobs.
Shut
I'm
the
sorry.
Fuck up. I'm giving it a command. Xbox, pull your fucking head out of your asshole. No? Okay, stop listening. No? Fuck you. There we go. Okay, so you broke the game. Thanks a lot. Man,
I really love
bringing you in. You make these Let's Plays so easy. So I love it. Should I just leave that on there? You want to enjoy that the rest of this fucking video, audience?
Yeah, top quality.
God damn it. You don't even have a controller and somehow you fucked it up. That's impressive.
This went from a B commentary to A really
God
fast.
God damn.
Where is he?
Your friend is and I just went and unplugged the Kinect. Maybe it was hands gone. His life.
Let's go find your precious treasure.
Let's go find Ellie. Damn it.
Because it's Troy Baker. Here.
The eagle did you know hunts that?
Rabbits. I did not.
Talion. And so shall we. That Troy Baker. He everywhere.
He's, yeah.
Been He's the guy. Things. How pissed off do you think Nolan North is? He used to be the guy. Although, not to knock Nolan North, because, I mean, it's whatever the fuck voice they want him to do, 90% of Nolan North is just him speaking.
Nolan North being himself.
Him being in The Last of Us is, like, one of the only roles I like, didn't know was Nolan North, because he does, like, really hard, really, like, he really throws his voice for the character. But, man, Troy Baker sounds totally fucking different every game he's in. Fucking kudos to the Bakester.
These towers were not built by the Dark Lord, but to challenge
I'm pretty sure it's him anyway. If it's not, oops.
Buried in darkness.
Like, just right off the bat, this...
No, this is Troy Baker,
Talion,
and that sword is the King's sword.
Talion?
You're done.
Yeah, that's exactly it. And he does, obviously, Joel in The Last of Us, and then Booker DeWitt in Bioshock. The fucking Joker. He sounds nothing like himself. It's good. I approve.
He's a versatile actor.
Holy shit. Fuck.
Is it dead?
That guy just got Loki. That's what Hulk did to Loki in the fucking Avengers movie.
A grog.
Except Loki didn't horribly
and
die.
At least 20 men to bring that beast out. Oh, then we must find another way.
Now you do it.
Surely you have the strength of 20 men.
What if I just shoot him with an arrow and I go,
just huh. Like slap him a little.
Yeah, so I have not encountered these guys yet. So I have no idea how
Charging
to take them
to the
down.
The cave's mouth will only lead us into the grog's jaws. A well-placed arrow will do the trick here.
Ah.
What does that mean?
You lure it over there to knack on that thing by shooting it down, I assume. So then while it's distracted...
Oh, I was like, knack on what? I didn't see it was a thing.
Yeah, it's
a ribcage. That was my vision there. Yeah, no, it's a bunch of meat. Yeah, that's what draws the Karagars, Karagors. I never fucking remember what they're called.
Karagor.
I think it's Karagors. The, like, monster things.
Oh, Jesus. I thought he saw you. It's very scary.
I got the sprint, man. That fucking sprint is useful. It's funny because when you're running on like level ground like this, you're looking for little boxes to jump over so you can do that sprint. Because it's every time you vault, when you hit the ground, you can press A and you'll
can
get
you
like
vault
a
over
boost.
Fires?
You cannot. You can run through fires and get fucking burned by fire.
Oh.
It doesn't really increase your speed though. You guys fucking go back underground.
They've burrowed.
Dig, diglet, dig. Dig, diglet, dig. Dig, diglet, dig.
Looks like the Grog won his fight against the Karagors.
Grog!
And now is ready for
that
another.
That is Karagors. I'm sneaking. This and Assassin's Creed comes to mind. This game doesn't really play like Assassin's Creed. It kind of just has some similar features to Assassin's Creed. It plays way more like Batman because it's the same people that made Batman and they're like, let's use that combat system there. But games in general like this, you got to imagine this is horrible for their backs. It makes me think of, like, the... Dude, you know what Talion could do if this didn't work out for him as a ranger slash dead guy? He could totally be a fucking server at the Alamo Draft House. He's just like...
Hey, guys, hi. How you doing?
Hey, can I help you? Yeah, what do you want?
Is
okay,
this
I'll
your
get
pizza
your
ray
okay, cool.
or is it not?
That's all I think of those people is how horrible their spines must be. That's their whole day, just crouching like that. There's a lot of paths going on here. There's some fucking mushrooms over there.
Those giant spiders are back that are
well,
the size
thank
of your
God.
Face.
That could have been bad. I hit the Wraith vision, and there's like 7 million paths everywhere. And I'm like, oh, there it is.
Is that that thing where you pull people's tongues out?
I think it's more the thing for forging, like with a blacksmith. That
it's a torture device from the Middle Ages.
But it might be used for that.
For when you speak out of turn.
Going back to they're forging something, I'm going to assume.
I assume the rings? No? Maybe?
I don't know.
Yes? How many were given to the elves and to the
okay,
dwarf
well,
lords?
The rings. I don't fucking know. Like a billion? Oh, so this dickhead's the guy that made them. Who the fuck is that? Is that fucking Sauron?
No. He wasn't elvish, was he?
I don't know what he was. He was
no
something,
idea.
Right? What was he? I mean, going to the expert on lore, what was it? Was he human or elvish?
Probably
or?
An Andalite, maybe a Yurk.
I'm just saying, like, he made the rings, and that dude behind him was like, oh yeah, give me the rings.
He was an Animorph, actually.
Such art, Celebrimbor.
Well, that's a stupid name. Celebrimbor.
Celebrimbor. My god. Greatest smith of the Second Age. I'd heard the stories, but
I remember my name now.
I made
I shaped the history of Middle-earth. I crafted the Rings of Power.
What?
Wow. I guess that really hits you in the lore hole, huh?
Sorry.
He just found out, too.
Fly, you fool.
I can't fucking fly. I can run. Shadow Strike. Oh, that's awesome. Okay.
But Sauron's rings was formed in the fires of Mount Doom. It wasn't forged by that dude. I think I just remembered. I'm pretty sure that's right.
Well, I mean, it was probably the same guy, though, right? Like, he probably went and did that, too.
Maybe.
People prefer to raise all their rings, press A to dodge your attacks. All right. So this move, instead of shooting, you push A, and it uses two arrows, and you warp right to the dude. So these are all the abilities that I don't have because fucking, you know, it's part of the story. Excuse me. I'm assuming that's just story related.
Yeah. You found out who forged the rings.
Let me fucking go ahead and get the fuck through this. Why go? It's not going. I don't know. He's not doing it. I don't know if I need to do it on an enemy, probably. Yeah, I'll have to wait for some dickheads to run over here. Hey, dickheads. Oh, shit.
Oh, he's back.
This is
bad.
Oh, my God. I don't know how to... Oh, fuck. I'll go up.
Grog rising.
Go. Why are you not going?
Jesus Christ.
Holy shit balls. That was close.
That attack is pretty awesome, though. I compared it earlier to an Ender Pearl, and it's very similar.
See ya, bitches! I was like Usain Bolt for a second there.
You were running with the pack.
Crap. Okay, you know, just, like, if you want to do it, that'd be great, but do it. He doesn't do it all the time. I don't know what I'm doing wrong.
Time out?
Guys, seriously, stop. You're being dicks. Oh, I have to do it on the fucking yellow guy? All right.
Interesting.
I know we're being that specific now. I can't believe I'm not dead yet. Oh, another amazing epic rune I have, which would come into effect now, like it's relevant, is I have a rune for my sword that I do 100% more damage when I'm lower than 25% health. So if I were to get into a fight right now, I'd do double damage per sword. I don't want to fight this thing, though. Get bolted.
And good riddance.
Ah, nice facing.
Wait till he gets outside to talk shit.
For all of this. That's why Sauron.
I wasn't even scared.
No, Bright Master is good. He looks after us.
Shut your insolent mouth.
Damn.
Ranger. He knows nothing of the Bright Master.
I know of his legend. How Sauron deceived you into making the rings.
Okay, question answered.
Tortured both you and your king.
Yeah, but I don't know if that dude was Sauron, but it might be. I don't know.
I have no memory of any
like you said, you and your king, so maybe that was the king.
Pretty sure it's the Elvish king.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
We dig up more treasures.
I'm saying the Elvish King who was in The Hobbit. I'm pretty sure he does join up with Sauron.
Mm-hmm. I'm just saying
through trickery or something.
The guy just said that Sauron tricked his king into doing it. So I'm saying that was probably the king standing behind it.
Okay, yes. That's exactly what I was going for. Okay, good. We're all on the same page.
I assume. I don't know shit about this. When do they go to Hogwarts? That's what I want to know. Where the fuck is Hagrid?
As are many.
Oh, that'd be badass if an owl just, like, drops something for you right
Where's
here.
The third-person fucking action-fighting Harry Potter game where I can cut heads off? That's what I want. Oh, so our Gollum quests are at an end for now. We have to do more of these before he comes back. I guess I'll just do this one because I'm right here.
I told you about my friend that I went to see Star Wars Episode 3 with.
Here we go.
Peter.
I don't know.
Like 10 minutes into the movie, he just stands up and he goes, "Where the fuck is Harry Potter?" And then he left the theater.
Which movie was this?
Star Wars Episode 3.
Yeah, he didn't miss much.
Yeah.
He saved about two hours of his life. God damn, that movie was so long and boring.
It was pretty bad.
Okay, I didn't push the button, sorry.
Definitely was one of those people who's dying of laughter by the end.
No!
Do not want.
Make yourself at home, Talion.
Place your head on the stick.
Valuable information from this one. Before he lost his head.
Or did you cut it off?
He's grown slow nothing. We're wasting precious time. Wasting time? We've learned where they are keeping our blasting powder. What need have I of blasting powder?
Tell us about you.
It's all part of the plan, my friend. Whatever leads us to the Black Hand is my only concern. So anxious to find the Black Hand. And by all means, I will take you to him.
Dafuk?
With any luck, the Uruks have yet to discover the secrets of the blasting powder. We will need to free my men to find out.
Do you believe the blasting powder can draw out the Black Hand?
I pray so. The enemy gathers at Uruk's Hollow, where many of my men are
enslaved. Sexy middle-earth asses.
I pray Eren
too is there.
You
can't even see my ass.
I will handle the Uruks.
I can in my
brain. Perhaps we can take a more stealthy approach and incapacitate them by using their weakness. Grog. Have you ever heard of Hithlis? It's toxic and is good for one thing. Poisoning orcs. Follow me.
Man, they're giving me like every ability, like mission after mission after mission.
When I deserted the
okay
Black Gate,
this.
I fell sick.
Because that's the next one I get. You poison the grog. That's a fucking ability. Learning how to put poison in a barrel.
Of the many, she is my most cherished. There are only so many camps my wife could have been taken to.
Do you believe she will be at this one?
My heart says yes.
I hope for your sake she is here, Gon.
My mind's telling me no!
Wow, really? Right here? Oh.
I was wondering what would happen if I shot him in the butt.
You'll never see your wife again.
You'll never see it coming. It's a lovely scenic route. Who's that? Whoops.
Oh, Jesus.
Be careful, Ranger.
Also, the Uruk-hai are the ones who were born from the lava. In, like, the embryos.
What?
Just don't worry about it.
Yeah, what the hell are you talking about?
Because I thought they were the Uruks, but they're not. They're Uruk-hai.
Right? So there's Orcs, there's Uruks, and there's Uruk-hais.
Yes.
Okay. I don't give a shit. I'm just going to stab all of them.
Good.
It just doesn't matter. I'm going to fucking kill everyone.
All of you are ugly. You're all going
down.
Yeah,
you are all fucking ugly. There's no doubt there. That's true. Oh, right in the gut. Fucking stabbed his belly. Oh, shit. No, you don't see me. No, you don't see me. Hang on. Gotta love the slow-mo.
Because I'm pretty sure at the point that we're at, Uruk-hais have not been created yet.
When do they get created?
They don't have the technology yet.
When do they get created?
Is it Two Towers, I think? I'm pretty sure Two Towers.
Well, that's like, I can't remember, like 60 years from now? I can't remember. This takes place after The Hobbit, but before Lord of the Rings, but I don't know what exactly the time frame is.
Harry's in his third year right now.
Really?
Yeah.
That's my favorite year.
Which is the one? Is that fourth year where they have the long hair?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's my least favorite year.
Goblet of Fire hair?
Yeah. Stupid.
They look so urban trendy, though.
Okay, what kind of fucking herbs do I need? I'm just picking up random shit. Did you make the poison? I don't know. I just grabbed a bunch of shit and threw it in
work?
The grog. I put in parsley, basil, and oregano. Do you think it'll kill him?
It looks gross.
I got a bunch of green plants and shit.
Follow me.
Wait for me, Hergon.
Where did you acquire this?
See, like that little rock? Whee! You're always looking for little rocks like that so you can run faster. Oh, shit. I almost failed.
I almost ran too fast. Run into the unknown.
You are proving yourself to be a strong leader. For a deserter.
That is only because I leave the hard work to men like you.
I take the easy way out.
Me too.
Yeah. You and this guy would get along.
Alright, what's the plan?
If you were telling him you wouldn't even, like, go complete the mission, you'd be like, ah, fuck it.
Dude, if I was Talion, I would just, like, be like, I'm dead. I'm a ghost. And I would just haunt people. I'd just hang out in this like, the spirit realm or whatever. Wraith vision, wraith realm, all day.
Just, like, poke orcs that
are on duty.
I would
just fucking wraith people.
I'm a haunted flower sack. Ooh.
God, we're doing a whole lot of fucking sneaking. I want to kill. I've barely got to kill anything so far. This is the third mission already this Let's Play, and I think I've killed, like, five guys.
In Mordor, even the flowers are of death.
There are far worse things than flowers here.
Man, your fucking face.
Unless you're allergic. Way to be considerate.
Collect herbs for poison. Oh, that's nice. Real successful hunt. Got my
What are the dog-like beasts called?
Those?
Yeah.
Those are Caragors.
Okay. And, did you get the ability where you can ride them?
Do you fucking think that's a dog?
It's kind of like a dog.
It's more like a fucking tiger or some sort of giant animal than a dog.
What kind
of,
like, sniffs like a dog? It's like...
Interesting. What are you doing over there? Did you get caught? You jerk off. That thing's gonna kill your ass. Fucking daddy will have to step in and take care of it, like always.
Did you get the skill where you can ride them? If you jump on them?
Yes.
Nice.
Satisfied? I saved your ass. There's another ability, it'll probably be the one I get after the Grog one, that I can actually fucking counter those things.
I thought it impossible.
Because right now you can just roll out of the way, that's it. But you get a Y counter move.
Darkness descends upon Mordor. Soon it will be impossible not to succumb.
When we realized we couldn't fight the orcs, we started dressing up like slaves, sneaking into their camps to free the others.
A bold strategy.
Not really. Mostly, we'd end up slaves ourselves. At least we came dressed for the part.
Fucking idiots.
When I was first
bold strategy. No, I was pretty dumb.
They told me you led the search party for my head.
I volunteered. Were you caught, our fellow rangers would have killed you. I could not let you suffer that fate.
I assume that was back, you know, when he was alive. That happened. I still don't quite grasp what the hell's going on with Talion. Like, he's dead, but somehow I can get killed.
I assume he somehow, like, managed to pull through, but, like, entered the Wraith world, and that helped him somehow survive.
He managed to pull,
like,
through.
Blend.
He got his fucking throat slit. He's dead, dude. For our purpose.
I look forward to seeing its effects up close.
I think he's undead. That's what I'm going for.
I don't know what the fuck he is. He's sexy.
He's a zombie, man.
I know that.
Sexy
well, I guess
zombie.
The green ones are the ones I gotta get. Don't mind me.
You really think he's sexy?
Welcome to part 3, where we collect plants. I think he's pretty good looking. He's like the manly version of Jon Snow. Like, Jon Snow should look like Talion.
You're right.
But
you're
he's like a
right.
fucking crybaby. Like,
Talion doesn't
perm his fucking hair.
Shed a single tear.
And like...
My feelings.
He was like, fuck, I'm dead. My wife and son got murdered. Shit.
You have to do is drop it
I'm a man.
Rock.
Will the orcs not smell the poison?
No.
Look, Jon Snow, you might be this one day. Probably not. You'll probably get murdered.
That's the thing, though.
That.
There are so many women in Game of Thrones, too, who are way more, like, not emotionally...
He's a crybaby.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know my real daddy.
Half of the female cast of Game of Thrones could beat the crap out of Jon Snow just because he cries so much.
Mommy. I meant mommy.
Yeah. Like, get Brienne of Tarth over there.
Don't be seen. These Uruks have killed many slaves for far less.
Yeah? Oh. Ability unlocked, poison grog.
See, he's got the sexy physical appeal and the same look as Aragorn. And he's a ranger. Is he Aragorn's dad?
No, I don't think so.
Probably
I mean,
not.
If anything, it'd probably be like his fucking grandfather, his dad.
Yeah.
I think it's like 50, 60 years later or something. I could have swore I heard 60 years somewhere, but
they
I might just
kids really late in Middle-earth.
Yeah, he was 75 when he had him.
Still kicking. No Viagra either. Good work.
What you got going on down here, huh? Huh?
They're digging up a dinosaur.
I'm gonna go for a brutalized kill on this one. It's called that because it's brutal. It would have been brutal if you saw it and didn't, like, check out that sweet rock.
That shoe was intimidating.
Yeah.
Fuck. Damn, are those boots leather?
Foiled again. Damn you, camera angle. I'll brutalize this guy. It's just, like, a more intense stealth kill, but you actually get several hits out of it. That is not it. That's another kill. I just hit B to drop down and I ended up jumping on his head. Hence, he was still alive. There you go. It's just every hit is actually a multiplier. So see, I got times six for killing that one guy.
Good lord.
It's good to brutalize somebody right before a fight because then you can run in and then just use your instant kill and shit. Okay, so how many dudes are down there? Four? Three.
Four.
Well, that's a human.
Five, if you count the one moving over to the left.
Well, you smoke it.
Oh, no. Oh, you're right.
Yeah, there's three.
Sorry.
Said, those are slaves. That dude right there is Hoenn. Trying to get the stealth kills before I move on. The bonus objectives really aren't worth that much. And you don't get, like, any items or anything. It's just, like, a little bit extra experience. M, which I think someone pointed out is supposed to be mithril, which makes sense, because...
Mithril shards.
Mithril's a thing in Lord of the Rings. I was collected fucking shitloads of Mithril, as they called it in Lego Lord of the Rings. But I still like to call it M.
Sounds like a drug.
Just getting my M level ups.
Yo, you want some M?
Oh, you're gonna get it. Oh, you just got it. It's like five stabs, at least. Stab. Alright, where the hell is the... I love that you go slow-mo, because if a guy fucking sees you, you can just shoot him right in the face, like, while he's looking at you. And then I also have one of my runes is, like, a 60% chance to refill my focus, which is what keeps it in slow motion, when I get a headshot. So if I headshot, like, five, six people in a row, I can just, like, odds are, just stay in slow-mo mode for a while, which is nice, for focus mode.
No wonder this stuff burns so well.
There's one doo-doo planted.
Wait! I smell something!
I shot that guy twice and then killed that guy. And then he didn't have time to fucking move. Oh, shit! Well, it doesn't matter because I was detected. God damn it. I got a little kill happy. Fair enough, it happens.
You got cocky.
Yeah, I did. I did for sure. Yeah, I don't give a fuck about the stealth kills. I'm just gonna try and fucking wrap this up. I'll get him anyway.
What was the beehive that was up?
The beehive, when you drop it, like, all the enemies in the area will fucking scramble. They'll just, like, run away. It doesn't really do any good in this specific instance.
I didn't know if it was part of the objective.
No, it probably works there because there's probably a barrel, like, right under it. So I imagine if you drop the beehive, then,
It'll cause it to explode.
It'll just fall and everybody will run away. So didn't I failed right here, right? Or no, I failed on the next one. Yeah, there's one right under me. Oh, somebody see me? Somebody sees me or a dead body or something. Okay.
No wonder this stuff burns so well.
Yeah, Grog, it's probably the dude right above me.
Nah, Grog probably tastes great. I'd drink it.
Grog? Yeah, yeah. Get some fucked up.
We should compare Grog to Riot Punch at some point.
Right, well, one's real, Lindsay.
There's probably recipes for Grog online, I'm sure.
But it's not the same. Oh, shit! That is a dude.
Based on how they describe it in the book. Close enough.
Alright. This would be a good mission to end on if I can actually fucking beat it.
You know, Elvish bread isn't real, but they serve it at the Alamo Drafthouse.
Yeah, but it's, like, not authentic. I don't give a shit.
Yeah, it's not magic. You can't, like...
And that's what I'm saying.
Eat a bite of it and be full all day.
Shit. Run. Oh, people are getting suspicious all over the place. Suspicions abound. Well, they probably found some dead bodies, but as long as they don't spot me, it's okay. I think. See how that white meter just filled back up? That's my focus mode. Crap! Fuck! That asshole underneath saw me. Shitball soup!
Right, maybe you get to a higher vantage point.
That was as high as I could go. I need to stop killing so many people, but it's hard. It's hard not to kill. I just want to kill everyone and then just fucking take my time. But I keep getting spotted, like, because people keep seeing me murder people. The sneaky ones are the hardest. Shut up. I do like that this game gives you a chance to murder people after they see you. It's not like some games, like especially Splinter Cell, if that guy saw you, boom, you're alerted.
Everyone
it's like,
TV,
how?
Yeah.
How? I stabbed the guy in the throat. How did he tell anyone? This game actually gives you the opportunity to run up to someone and fucking murder them. And then they ain't telling nobody nothing. I probably have to kill the fucking archers behind me and shit.
No,
but can they attract people nearby, like, if you're about to kill them and they just kind of scream for a second? Or like, ah, is it like,
yeah.
Oh, what was that?
Yeah, but that guy was by himself. If you get somebody by themselves and stab them, it doesn't matter that they saw you. As long as they don't, like, have ample time to set an alarm off. Or in this case, because it's don't be detected. You will fail if that one guy detects you, but you get, like, a second or so to kill him first. See, they're on to me. I'm killing too, indiscriminately. I don't know if that's a word. I feel like it is. Alright, so there's...
I want to say yes, but you know.
Somebody over there. Well, drop that anyway. I also don't know if those things can fuck me up. I assume they can. I've never... been around them when I dropped one. But I assume they'll kick my ass if I run in there. Alright. Okay, hit the... Seriously? There you go. Alright. Making some progress. So what do we got? We got two guys down there, three guys.
There's one more to the right. Yeah, right there.
Hey, drink it up. Drink up that grog, yo.
Tasty, tasty. Do you get the satisfaction of watching them die from your poisoning?
If they died, I would.
Hurry up.
Another one bites dust.
There you go.
Another one bites dust. And another one's gone, and another one's gone. Another one bites the dust. Hey, they're
don't
not fucking
you
dead, so I'm gonna help along.
Freddie Mercury.
Dead now.
Yeah, close enough.
They were poisoned.
It was a long-lasting
with
poison.
An arrow to the head. Well, I don't know. They might not have had any yet. The other dudes might have had some, and they didn't.
See, the people are so, like, disheveled now because they're slaves that I keep confusing them for orcs. And I'm like, oh!
Yeah.
Or urks, I should say. Uruks.
Oryx. Orkix.
Oryx challenge. Either way, they all suck. Oh.
Is this, like, the vacuum thing?
Yeah.
I got it.
That guy's probably dead, right?
What guy?
The guy who did the Oryx commercials. Mr. Oryx,
I mean,
I guess.
He might be, but why would he? I wouldn't expect it. I mean, that was only like 10 years ago. Guy wasn't 100.
Fair enough.
How the fuck am I going to get over there? Is there anybody over there? Who's there? You got a green asshole.
The very sick Earth.
Nobody's on that side. Fuck it. I should be able to just walk on over. Third time's a charm.
Can you sneak in there? The bar was bent.
I can, but that doesn't help me.
I just want to see what's in there.
Fucking barrels over here. Go, 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 go. Do the fucking thing.
All he has to do is wait.
Now, waiting? I'll go in here.
Oh.
No, I won't. Never mind. That's a nice transition.
Flip, flip, Philadelphia. Flip, flip, Philadelphia.
Oh, what
flip,
just happened flip, is you just flip. Drank a cup of poison.
Adelphia.
Come with me. Come with me.
Don't drink the grog.
It's a bad batch.
Hey, yo, Boo, why are you acting a fool? You crazy, girl.
Sweet leg warmers.
You know I was only coming up in here to save your ass.
I thought I'd never see you again.
I mean, Talion did most of the work, but I'm here too.
I knew you were alive.
This is a very emotional moment.
And then an arrow goes right through both their heads.
Jesus.
Hey, remember your wife?
We'll battles, Talion. But we will find our peace.
Then.
Adelphia.
They're in love, Michael.
The outcast success.
Michael, they've been reunited.
Ability point gained. Sweet. All right, so let's check my my upgrades here. I had one already, but I was saving it.
I see you're not crying from that last scene.
No, I'm fine.
I'm not either. Don't worry.
I'm perfectly fine. So I got some shoulder charge I don't really give a shit about. The daggers is kind of useful. I don't really use them that much. Oh, this is fucking good. So this here, usually when you press B, you know, you hit one dude. But now when you hit B, as you see in the little preview there in the upper right-hand corner, you stun, like, anyone around the guy. So it's like, bam! So you can stun, like, two or three dudes at once.
Nice.
Fire arrow, you can shoot fire arrows. I mean, that's, you know, they cause huge explosions if used on barrels or campfires. Put one in this for now. I'm saving one just for the shit back here, because every time you level up, it takes longer to get to the next level, obviously. And the best abilities are at the bottom. But the reason why I'm kind of hanging back is you get the yellow ones for free. Like, I'll get this one in a mission, I'll get this one in a mission, but then I'll have to buy this one. So I don't want to just, like, have to spend, like, forever leveling up to get the shitty abilities. Like, I'm trying to get them and clear them before I get to the bottom. Because I assume the game gives you enough experience to get all of them. Because there's no end. Like, I think even when you beat the game, you can kind of free roam and run around and get experience and shit. So you should be able to level up all your stuff. And as you can see over here, I'm almost done. I just need a couple more things over here. And then you can move on to these, like, super abilities. Which is pretty sweet. Going back to the relics, or the runes. So this ability, what this does, this is what you were thinking of earlier. When you activate it, you're basically, you get instant kill for 20 seconds. You can do it as many times as you want. And I picked up a rune that increases that to 30 seconds, which is pretty fucking handy. And I get the same thing for the bow. So, I think that's, what, 3 missions? It's pretty good.
Yep.
I've got... Shit, I got one more left.
Rescued that dude's wife. She's good.
Is this the fucking rat bag mission? Yeah. Rat bag, you fuck. Yeah, I got the dude's wife. Gollum's fucking off somewhere. I'm assuming Gollum is probably in the next map. Like, this might be the last mission of this area. And then I assume the next area will have a whole bunch of missions, and that's probably where you continue with the Golem.
Do you move about Middle Earth, or are you basically in Mordor the entire time?
I assume you're in Mordor the whole time. I mean, because, like, this is the only area in the game, and then there's only one or two more after this.
Oh, okay.
But I think that about wraps it up for part 3. Got a couple missions done, did some shit, not bad.
Poison some people?
Poison the shit out of somebody.
They're Urks, they're not people, right?
I mean, I think I'd still classify them as a somebody, right? Like, they're a... What's a person?
I don't know.
Do you need to be a human to be a person?
That's a good question, actually.
Or can you be a person if you're an orc?
I
don't know. These questions and more answered in part 4.
Uric empowerment!
Looks like he's taking a dump, ready? He's, like, taking a shit, and then just, like, pans up, and then cut to black.
Black gate.